Hey guys, now in this video we shall see the two most important concepts such as runway design and taxiway design from airport planning and design. Now let's start with the first question. The first question is, the data for an hottest month of a year gives mean of maximum daily temperature as 44.62 degrees Celsius and mean of average daily temperature as 28.21 degrees Celsius. Then what is the airport reference temperature? So here two data are given, one is mean of maximum daily temperature, another one is average daily temperature. Now we have to find airport reference temperature by using the two data given. That is one simple formula that to be followed as per ICAO. We shall see now. So the answer is option B, 33.62 degrees Celsius. So first we have to denote, like T suffix M is nothing but mean of maximum daily temperature, that is 44.62 degrees Celsius, and TA is 28.12 degrees Celsius, that is average daily temperature. So TA and TM are given in the question itself, and we have to find this airport reference temperature as per ICAO. ICAO means International Civil Aviation Organization. So that organization has given one formula, that is this one, TA plus TM minus TA by 3. So just substitute both the data here to get the answer for ART as 33.62 degrees Celsius. So this is a simple and important formula for to find ART, that is airport reference temperature. Now we shall see more about more other details about temperature in basic runway length calculation. So as per ICAO, International Civil Aviation Organization, basic runway length, that is BRL, we can abbreviate like that, should be further increased by 1% for every per degree Celsius rise. For 1 degree Celsius rise in temperature, we have to increase the basic runway length by 1% after the correction applied for elevation. That we shall see in the second question. Just be clear with the with this statement alone. We have to increase 1% for 1 degree Celsius rise in temperature. So in the airport reference temperature above the standard atmospheric temperature at that elevation. We shall see this point in detail in the second question. And next point is, temperature gradient becomes zero above the altitude where temperature is minus 15.6 degrees Celsius. So this is one fact. Temperature gradient becomes zero above the altitude where temperature is minus 15.6 degrees Celsius. And as per ICAO, standard atmospheric temperature at mean sea level is taken as 15 degrees Celsius. So standard atmospheric temperature at MSL is taken as 15 degrees Celsius. So these are some important things regarding temperature in the calculation of runway length. Now we shall see the second question. So second question is to find the corrected runway length after applying necessary correction for elevation and temperature as per ICAO recommendation, and therefore we have to involve the gradient correction as per FAA. FAA means Federal Aviation Administration as per United States. And they have given some four data. One is basic runway length 2100 meter, elevation as 100 meter, effective gradient as 0.6%, and temperature data as in first question. So we have to take the temperature data as we have seen in the first question. Let's move on to options. So option A, 2871 meter, option B, 2563 meter, option C, 2389 meter, option D, 3000 meter. So after correction for elevation and temperature, what will be the corrected runway length? That we have to find. So here the answer will be option A, 2871 meter. Now we shall see how it is calculated. So first we shall see the given data. First BRL, basic runway length, elevation 100 meter, effective gradient as 0.6%, and ART that we have found in the first question itself. ART is 33.62 degrees Celsius. Now we shall see one by one the corrections. First correction is elevation correction. Elevation correction, in this we have to increase 7% of BRL, that is basic runway length, per 300 meter rise in elevation. So this is the basic concept or the basic thing in elevation correction. So we shall see the correction for this data. So 7 by 100 into 100 by 300. So how 7% for every 300 meter rise. But here elevation is 100 meter only. So that's why 100 by 300 into the basic runway length. So this 49 meter is the correction or the positive correction for elevation. Then what will be the corrected length? 2100 plus 49. So this is the corrected length after elevation correction application. Next is the temperature correction. So after correcting for elevation, we have to follow the temperature correction. And we know the standard atmospheric temperature at given elevation is given by the formula. This one, TS is equal to 15 minus 0.0065 into given elevation. So given elevation is 100 meter. So just substitute 100 here and 15 minus 0.0065 into 100 gives 14.35 degrees Celsius. We already know the ART value from the first question, that is 33.62. And we have to find the difference between ART and TS. So that is 33.62 minus 14.35 degrees Celsius gives the plus 19.27 degrees Celsius. So for temperature correction, we have already seen in the first question what we have to do: increase 1% for every degree rise in the temperature. Here 19.27 degrees Celsius rise is there. So we have to apply 1% into 19.27 into the corrected runway length after elevation correction. That has to be written here, not 2100. Whatever the latest value or the elevation correction we have done, that runway length has to be taken here, and we have to get the correction value for temperature. So in this problem, we got 414.11 meter as the correction for temperature. So what will be the corrected length? 2563.11 meter is the corrected length after temperature correction. So after getting two corrections, elevation and temperature, we have to check for the correction in percentage. So this is the corrected value, 49 for elevation, 414.11 meter for temperature by basic runway length into 100. Will give 1% of correction. So that percentage should be less than 35% as per ICAO and FAA recommendations. If at all it is the percentage in correction is greater than 35%, then further research has to be done for correction and for getting basic runway length values. So the total correction in percentage should be less than 35%, then only it will be correct. Runway length. Now we shall see the effective gradient correction. So gradient correction is nothing but we have to increase the corrected runway length after temperature correction by 20% for every 1% of effective gradient. Here the effective gradient is given as 0.6%. So that's why 20 by 100 into 0.6 by 1 actually into 2563. What is 2563? The corrected runway length after temperature correction. So this value is taken here. So for this gradient correction, we got the value as 307.56. Therefore, 307.56 plus 2563 gives 2870.56. So that is rounded off to 2871 meter. Therefore, this is the basic idea of runway length correction and runway length problem. Now we shall move on to third question. That question is also based on runway length, but one thing is the landing case. The corrected runway length for landing case, when the basic runway landing length is 2200 meter for an elevation of 300 meter will be. Take a temperature value as seen in the first question for just assumption. So what will be the corrected runway length for this landing case? When the basic runway length, runway landing length is given as 2200 meter. For elevation of 300 meter, what will be the corrected runway length for landing case? So here the answer is option D, 2354 meter. Now let's see the calculation part. So for landing case, only elevation correction is applied. So this is the main point to be noted for landing case. In case they have mentioned as a landing case, then we have to apply only the elevation correction. Therefore, 7% per 300 meter rise, right? So here already the elevation is 300 meter. So we have to increase 7% the basic runway length, that is 2200. So 1.07 into 2200, that will be equal to 2354 meter. This is the corrected runway length for this landing case. Now we shall see other details about runway design. So first point is, wind blowing in the same direction of landing or takeoff shall be called as tailwind. If the wind is blowing in this direction, in this landing direction, or we can say takeoff direction, then that will be called as tailwind. Headwind means the wind blowing opposite to the direction of takeoff, you can say, and that will give greater lift force. So if the lift force is greater, then we require shorter runway length when compared to wind blowing in the direction which is in the direction of takeoff. So the orientation of the runway should be such that the headwind is the prevailing wind, that is opposite to the direction of taking off. Then only we get a greater lift force. Then what happens is shorter runway length. And next is the calm period. Calm period means the percentage of time during wind intensity less than 6.4 km per hour. Whenever in a given duration of time, in that time, in wind intensity is less than 6.4 km per hour, then we call that duration or that period as calm period. And as per FAA recommendation, minimum wind coverage in a mixed air traffic shall be 95%. And in some cases, very high traffic, 98% can be there. So minimum wind coverage shall be 95% for mixed air traffic as per FAA recommendations. FAA means Federal Aviation Administration. And the last point is, permissible limit of crosswind component shall be 15 km per hour to 35 km per hour. So 15 km for small aircraft and 20 to 25 km per hour for medium size aircraft, and for big aircraft it shall be 35 km per hour for the crosswind component. And there are three cases to determine BRL. What is BRL? Basic runway length. What are the three cases? One is normal landing case, another one is normal takeoff case, third one is engine failure case. So among these three cases, whichever the case gives the maximum or the largest basic runway length, that value has to be taken. And first is the normal landing case. That means the aircraft will stop within 60% of landing distance or runway length. So that only called as normal landing case. And next is the normal takeoff case. 115% of liftoff distance will be required to each height of or elevation of 10.5 meter. That will be the normal takeoff case. And in case of engine failure case, basic runway length considers the clear way or stop way, or both. Clear way or stop way is for emergency purposes. So in case of engine failure case, BRL considers the clear way or stop way or both the things. So among these three, whichever the value of runway length is higher, that will be taken. So these are some points about the runway design. Now we shall move on to fourth question. So fourth question is based on taxiway design. Here the exit taxiway is to be designed for Boeing 707 with a turn off speed of 70 km per hour. We have to calculate the turning radius of exit taxiway using the following data. So data A is if lateral friction coefficient as 0.13 and capital W 18.0, that is wheelbase, tread off male, thread of main landing gear is 7.2 meter, and taxiway width gives given as 22.5 meter. So here we have to use three criteria, and among the three criteria, whichever the value is greater, that value has to be adopted as radius of exit taxiway. So here the answer is option A, 301.52 meter. Now we shall see how it is calculated. So first formula is radius of taxiway as V square by 125 f. Here we have to V, that is the velocity or the turn of speed, has to be substituted in kilometer per hour. So that's why 70 square by 125 into coefficient of lateral friction, that is 0.13 as given. Among substituting all the values, we get the value of the radius of exit taxiway as 301.52 meter. There is another formula that is given by Horonjeff's equation. R is equal to 0.388 into capital W square divided by T by 2 minus S. Here W is given as 18 meter, T is 22.5 meter. What is that? Taxiway with this 22.5. We have to be more careful about the notations. Taxiway with this denoted as capital T. Capital W is wheelbase. And capital S, that is here, is nothing but summation of oleo distance and T dash by 2. What is T dash here? The tread of main landing gear, that is the T dash value. That is given as 7.2. Oleo distance is 6 meter. In general, we have to take this oleo distance as 6 meter. So 6 plus 7.2 by 2. That will give an answer in meter. That has to be substituted here. Capital T is 22.5 as given. Capital W is 18 meter as given. Just substitute all the values to get the radius of taxiway as per Horonjeff's equation, which is nothing but here 76.8 meter. And there is another criteria for minimum radius. So minimum radius of taxiway for a subsonic aircraft, here they have mentioned Boeing 707. This Boeing 707 is a subsonic aircraft. So minimum radius for this aircraft, of the taxiway for this aircraft, is 120 meter. In case of supersonic aircraft, it will be 180 meter. So here we have three values, 301.52, 76.8, 120 meter. So among the three values, we have to consider only the largest value, that is 301.52. So option A is the correct answer. Now we shall see fifth question. So fifth question, which of the following gives the number of gate positions in an airport? Option A, option B, option C, and option D. This is a typical formula that we have to consider to get the number of gate positions in an airport apron. Here the correct option is option C, that is capacity of runway divided by 60 into 2 into average gate occupancy time. And unit of runway capacity, that is capacity of runway, is in moments per hour. This is a simple formula. So we have learned the correction formula from runway design, and we have also learned the radius of exit taxiway, and at last we have learned the number of gate positions in an airport. That is the formula for number of gate positions in an airport. So that's all about this video. If you like this video, please like, comment, and share with your friends. Thank you. And please subscribe the channel right now. And also watch the suggested videos. Thank you for watching.